Hi guys, and welcome back to SiteEnch. In today's video, I'm going to show you the construction of the pile caps. And this is going to be actually the first video from the pile caps, as I want to show you the bigger pile cap, like a core cap as well. In 2 days, I'm going to show you the typical pile cap, what you need to have a look at when you're constructing the pile caps. And then we're going to jump to the bigger one, and I'll try to show you the construction of the slip form as well, and then how the slip form goes up then later. So yeah, let's go. So this is, guys, how we're going to be starting the pile caps. You see my lines here. This is actual line for the pile cap itself. And what I always do, I mark the offset line as well. I mark it on the other side, the 2 meter offset, whatever offset you're going to do. It's about 2 meters, let's say, at least. So you're going to lose that line, because as we can see here, we step it. So the dig itself is going to be bigger than the, this is actually crane base, but all the pile caps, it's the same story. You see the laser, I set the laser. That's the first thing we're going to be doing. And you're going to see everything on my drawings video when I'm going to be covering this. As I said before, each video on site will be covered by the each video on the drawing series. So yeah, that's it. We exposing the piles now. We're going to be cropping the piles. That's going to show you later. Blinding everything and step by step. So yeah, let's go to the next part. So that's the next step. When we have a dig already done, we just have to crop the piles. You see the cropper there, using a digger for it. Cropper, of course, the size of the cropper depends on the size of the piles, and Mr. Cropper, they call it. And then yeah, that's how it looks. You see the blue marks down there, that's a cutoff level. The lads actually getting ready. You see the two lads there, and so that's the next step. And next one, blinding, I'm going to show you, and of course before we start the pile testing as well. So we're gonna blind this today. Just before blinding, I'm gonna show you the old piles are cut now to the level. This is the nice cutoff level. And I want to show you one more thing. I showed the loose bead, yeah? So all loose beads like this, they have to go. It happens when you break in, sometimes it's loose bead, but it has to go, and the structural concrete has to go around it. So it's not the end of the world if it's broken, but the all loose beads have to go, as I said. Oh, another one here, I think. We're gonna get rid of it. Yeah. Yeah, and then the rebar has to be cut as well, as this is actually higher than top of the concrete. And we got 40 times diameter for the rebar anchorage minimum. So I'm gonna cut this 1500 above the cutoff level. I think the guys already marked it here, you see. So just a little bit cut, so it's not gonna be clashing with the top steel. And I think that's it in this part of works. So time for testing now. We have a tester here. I'll show you how it looks now. That's, guys, how integrity test is looking. So you're gonna be doing that all the time before you start working with a pile caps and capping beam as well. You saw that graph on that little tablet. It's gonna show that based on that hitting with the hammer, it shows the integrity of the pile. It's gonna tell us if the pile is cracked somewhere, or yeah, there's some incontinuities in the concrete. So that's it, that's the next one, and then all of them has to be checked this way. Then integrity pile report gonna be sent to us or to you, in that case on your job, and then you're good to go with the works. So the concrete here, the next stage is the blinding, and it's very important to have it very accurate. The more accurate, the easier gonna be later for us. So what I did, I actually set my EDM here, and I'm checking the level. I got here marked on the pile the perfect level for the cutoff. So I know from here it's the blinding gonna be 75 mil lower. So the projection of the piles are 75 mil as usual, really. So I'm just gonna set my laser somewhere here at a quite comfortable level for the lads, so they don't have it, you know, the stuff too high. They can control it easily. So blinding carries on. I set the laser, as you can see there, on one of the piles. That's gonna be actually the next pile cap. We obviously did that a little bit bigger to allow workers to work around it when they're gonna be constructing the steel for the crane base. Yeah, so as you can see, that's the blinding. The guys got the level there. They spread in the concrete. And then, yeah, I'm gonna be keeping an eye on them. So this is very good. And then with the pile caps, just probably with the smaller pile caps, I think the lad's gonna be using here the prefab cages in terms of steel fixing. So the ready-made cage is gonna be coming, you're gonna be dropping them in the position and probably marking the columns on top of them later after the backfill. But that's all very similar. So I'll try to show you that one as well, but this is the perfect example for the pile cap. So after our blinding is ready, we, in this case, and in some caps, you're gonna need the cellcore. On this job, I typically never put the cellcore, the core deck underneath the caps. I would we using this underneath the slab, and I believe that core deck gonna be underneath all the basement slab here, which is the heave protection. I'm gonna tell you a little bit more maybe in the drawing video why you need it and what you need it for. And this, obviously, the depth of this is going to determine the level of digging and everything. So you need to be very careful and check these things as well, as they might be shown on another drone. So after the blinding is done and the heave protection board is on, which I showed you, there is a time to steel fixer. So that's the steel here came for this pile cap. You see some shirlings, some big L bars, and then the main bar, main bar is behind me here. They all 32 mil bars, but that's how they come. So you're gonna have a tag here. It says H32, it's 32 mil bar. You got the bar mark here, it's bar mark number 4. And that's it, really. So that's how it comes. And it depends, I'll try to show you how I do the columns myself. As there's more complicated drawings and more stuff, I'll try to use different tag colors, like red for the bottom and blue for the top, for instance. And then depending how much and how complicated is the rebar drawing, I'll try to make it easier for fixers, as this really can make your life much easier. I think that's it. You see the links here for the column. Here are the starter bars, the long ones, as the pile cap is 1750 millimeters, so they have to be around 1 meter above it, above the concrete. And yeah, I'm going to show you how the fixers fixing the steel, and then when it's going to be ready, when we pour in it. Guys are laying the core deck now. This is second crane base. I'm going to set now the drainage. I put already where the leg's going to be, so the guy's going to cut in the core deck for me. And then what I'm going to do now, I check on the cut drawing how the line of the, put myself here 1470 and 1455 on the other side. So I'm going to be doing the just the offset from this line. I got this line in the EDM, so I need offset 1470 to the line. And I'm going to mark myself level as well, level on the blinding, and we're going to measure off the blinding later to the bottom of the pipe. That's going to be our invert level. And then, yeah, I just show you this when it's going to be installed. So let's go to the next step. Yeah, so same story, the other side from that line offset. That's, you can find actually on my setting out drawing where the reference line in is. And then we're gonna looking for 1455 here. Yeah, 1455. That's what I got now. I'm just gonna mark it there. I check later the reflectorless, the level here of the blinding. And then I just gonna measure with the tape from that level to the invert level of the pipe what I gonna need. I'll show you that later anyway. So guys, when you do the pile caps, you need to, like you're gonna see on the construction drawing series, we're gonna go through all the drawing services, drainage, pile cap, schedule probably, to just double check the cutoff levels, everything. You're gonna see that step by step. But what I'm doing now, I'm just marking the, I don't know if you can see the laser there. You actually can see this, yeah. I marked it on the bar, that's gonna be invert level of our pipe. I actually used the blinding before, but just, I got my EDM set. So I just want to make sure this is just perfect. And then, yeah, that's it. You're going to see the pipe later. I'm just do like a pre-pour inspection, just last check before we pour. And that's how the pile caps are constructed, really. And if it's crane-based, I'm actually showing this as a pile cap. That's how you're going to be doing the pile caps, unless you're using the prefab cages. But crane anchor, how we set the crane anchor, you're going to see on the crane-based video. I'll just do that as a separate video, setting the crane base for the crane tower. So you can see the pipe in. The first is in, is a 3 meters pipe time saver one. I'm going to tell you about maybe types of pipes more in the drawing video covering this bit, the pipe caps. But yeah, the pipe is in. You got my invert level here, the line for the guys, the other side as well, the same story. And this pipe cap, I'm going to have two columns as well. So obviously all the pipe caps, there will be some columns, unless it's going to be core caps, you're going to have the walls. It depends on the caps. Yeah, the core caps is interesting. I'm going to show you. I'm probably going to find some videos from my last job. We're preparing the crane base for the backfilling now. We have to actually backfill it slowly and then carefully from each side, slowly and slowly, not to move anything. And obviously after we're going to do that, I'm going to double check the crane anchor position. I'm going to double check the pipe as well. And after the backfilling, I'm going to mark two columns as on this pile cap here. There are going to be two columns coming. Anchor in there, top steel. There is only top one to come on top of it. We got the lightning protection here connected. This is a tape. Now it's going in two legs. That's what design wanted. So we got one here, one on the opposite corner. And then, yeah, after rebuffing, I'm going to mark the columns. I'm going to double check everything, and then I'm going to show you the pour. So guys, this is the last check actually I'm doing before pour. We're pouring tomorrow. I also do a survey of the pipe. Actually, I'm going to show you. It's installed now. I showed you that before, but I'll shoot the top of the pipe. I changed the height target for it's 105 mil. So I'm gonna have the invert level recorded straight in and don't have to take anything off. Yeah, so that's it really. The guys got two columns to be installed there and wait for the pour.